dead dogs. That's good.
What?
Oh, there was a fire at the puppy mill. That's fucking sad.
Oh, sweetheart, you don't have to last longer for me. Pop off, daddy. Yum, yum. Here, let me get your balls.
What? No, 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 no. I'm just Googling sad shit for this monologue I'm doing.
What the fuck? Jesus fucking Christ.
What? I didn't... You don't have to get
off.
Why
am I even sneaking into your trailer? I mean, are you even into this anymore?
Sorry, it's just... I finally have some real emotional stuff to do in this scene, and I just... I want to show my range. You know what I mean? It's what's going to get me my next gig.
You mean our next gig?
Yeah, our next gig.
Yeah.
I mean, there was a massive earthquake the other day, but it's like another earthquake. You know what I mean? It's like, there was one the other day, and now there's one. It's like, I don't really think I can get the feels about, like, that two in the row thing, so... You know, but these dogs, man.
You know, Strasburg says that you need to find your emotional truth.
Yeah, but who cares what the caterer thinks, you know?
Is there something that you could pull from your real life?
My driver hit a dog once.
Oh my god, that's perfect. That's awful. Was it okay?
Yeah, it was fine. Just a little damage to the fender.
Chase, we'd like to invite you to set.
Yo, Chase!
Hey, Tyler, what's up?
How's the influencing going? No, it's great. I actually just did a video with the Make-A-Wish kid.
Mm-hmm.
I can't tell you how good it feels to meet these terminally ill kids and influence their final purchases. It's like...
Yeah, no, it really seems like you're doing a lot of good for brands.
Yeah, hell yeah. No, but what I actually really want to do is get a show like yours.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, you've got the number one show on a kids' network. That's sick, man.
Yeah.
You must be so bummed it's coming to an end. Hey, look, you gotta holler at my sister on Instagram. She loves you.
Really? Is she cute?
She's 9. And she's a legit dummy. I mean, she's like redoing the second grade. That's cool. I've got an audition with Christopher Nolan, so I gotta go anyway.
What? How?
Your co-star, Daryl, he hooked me up, you know, with an audition. It's close to Nolan. He's got a big part in the project, so. I'm sure he'll hook you up too.
All right, thanks.
Oh, and don't forget to holler at my stupid sister either, okay? See ya.
Yo, D, how was your weekend?
Oh, wow. That's some transparent shit, man.
Sorry, what?
You and I, we only talk between action and cut. You clearly heard about Nolan.
Yeah. I was just gonna congratulate you about...
Well, you used to bring the middle of the loaf to work. Uh-huh. You know, the tasty shit. But this season, you've been tossing around crusts. And ain't nobody like crusts. There may be some friendless losers, you know, but no one cares about them.
Listen, man, I mean, I'm sorry if I've been a little, you know, out of it. I'm trying to do important work. I'm, like, really passionate about. What's up?
The important work is the work you've been hired to do.
Absolutely. Thank you. I appreciate that. It means a lot. So about the Nolan, do you think...
Forget about it. Mm-hmm. You don't have the chops for Nolan.
Moments, people!
Head! Oh. And you know that scene you wanted to shoot?
Yeah.
Lenny cut it.
Huh?
Lenny cut it. It was all crusts. Ouch, ouch. Come on. Easy. Thank you. All right.
What the fuck, Lenny? I asked for one scene in the whole show.
You know I don't like that colorful language. Relax. Have a lollipop.
I have a fucking lollipop, Lenny.
Fine. Take a breath. It was a beautiful scene, but it was too emotional. It didn't fit the show.
I need to show some range.
This isn't that kind of show. In this episode, your pet dragon is taking massive dumps in the principal's yard. It's not exactly Chinatown.
We're supposed to look out for each other, Lenny. You think I wanted to FaceTime your niece the other week?
Aw, you gotta make time for the fans.
She's 30, and I think she was masturbating.
Okay, that's regrettable. I didn't know she was gonna do that. Again, look. This is the second to the last episode of the show ever.
So?
So? Your audience doesn't want a sob story, Chase. You know what they do want? They want you giving them the loudest belch you could muster.
Chase, the dragon. Oh, Cornelius. You must have great eyesight from eating all those carrots.
Oh, I do. I can see trouble coming your way right now.
Chase, Mom said we could drive Cornelius to school today.
No way.
Too bad, Chase. It's our turn.
Not gonna happen.
Whoa. Dad!
I wanted a dog. Anything dragon-related, ask your mom.
Mom! I'm coming! Keep your pants on.
What's the matter now? Chase won't let us ride Cornelius to school.
He's my pet. I ride him to school every day.
Well, we should have a turn.
Do you want to help take care of him?
Sure, no big deal.
So,
you want to walk him? Do you have any idea what comes out of him on those walks?
I make a mess.
Don't forget this, girls.
Maybe we'll just take the bus.
That's what I thought. Aw, it's okay, Cornelius. We're all gross sometimes.
Oh, Chase!
Let's ride, pal!
Vera, new PA.
Smoke show.
What was that about?
What? I don't know.
Hey, you wanna get some grub with me, buddy?
Yeah, no, I would, but I got a thing I gotta go to.
All right, I gotta go. I'm sorry. Rain check.
Yo, have you seen that girl, Vera?
Hell yeah. Already called dibs on her.
Right.
How'd shooting go this morning?
We should be charged with war crimes for what we did on that set.
Oh, forget about it. The shit's almost over and you're about to blow the fuck up. Speaking of which, my screenplay.
Right, your space opera.
It's set in space, but it's about my life. It's an allegory. Exposes a seedy underbelly of corporate America.
You work at Kinko's.
FedEx Kinko's. And you're penciled into play? Bobby, he's riddled with teen angst, just like me.
You're 40 years old.
The angst is still in there. It never goes away. Got some people coming by our place tonight after dinner at your parents'.
Our place?
Well, I live in the pool house, so yeah.
Look, I'm not sure I'm in the mood for a party after today.
We haven't had a party in 3 weeks. Remember those honeysuckles from Fresno I told you about? They're coming. They'd be impressed by a celeb. Why don't you pop by, help Uncle Bobby empty his ball bag?
Jesus.
What? We can make it a four-way. I only got the one dick.
Okay.
Fine, I'll finish them both off. You can slip that after the oral.
What's up, PJ? What do you got for me?
A nice paycheck if you are up for a soda commercial in Thailand.
Ooh, that's bullshit.
Total bullshit. Where even is Thailand?
Nice haircut, Bobby. You should kill yourself. Why do you bring your uncle to our meeting?
You're useless.
If I write you a check for $5, will you fuck off?
I want it in cash.
Okay. Shut the fuck up. The dragon on my show just booked a Christopher Nolan film.
Well, they say Daryl's the next Daniel Day-Lewis.
Who says that?
Daryl does. But he says everyone is saying it.
Okay, well, Daryl is an alcoholic, and he shit himself in that costume 5 times.
Badass.
All I need is an opportunity, okay? Just get me in the door, and I'll do the rest.
My phone is ringing off the hook. okay? But it's all for kid shows.
Yeah, because all I've been doing is acting like a buffoon for 4 years.
Yeah, that's what the network wants.
Yeah, well, I have a lot to offer. And they're fine with me doing shit, even if it makes me miserable?
Yeah, it makes them a fuckload of money.
Get me an indie film.
I am trying.
When I tell the ladies that Chase is my nephew, they don't even know who he is. I have to send them links, PJ. Links. And that ain't baller.
Chase is a star. Okay, everyone in this goddamn place knows who he is.
Chase, caramel macchiato for Chase. Chase.
Chase, that barista is an idiot.
It's not about the fame, PJ. I just want to do meaningful work.
I
right?
get it. I will keep hustling, Chase. I will never give up on you, Chase, ever.
Better not, scumbag. But seriously, we really appreciate your hustle, Peach.
Great.
Oh, and in the meantime, I need you to check out this script, ASAFP.
Yo, Chase, can I hit that?
What?
I'm sorry, Chase. She's so stupid.
Your burp was so rad this morning.
Your burp is, like, so much better than Daryl's, but don't tell him I said that.
Enough, Bree. God.
We want to ask for some career advice now that the show's ending.
I've got some fucking advice. Quit the business.
These people don't care about you, and they make you dance like trained monkeys.
Time to dance. Let's ride!
Brendan, we're eating.
Did you tell him about Brendan?
Brendan scored 3 goals today.
3 goals? Not to see that. Mm-hmm.
Guys, he plays street hockey in the front of our house.
Right. And you're on TV.
I didn't say that.
You didn't have to.
We're proud of both of you, Chase.
You know, 3 goals for him is like an Emmy for you.
Mm. And you don't have an Emmy.
Yeah.
Right.
Brendan, come on. Strong meal in there.
Thank you,
Bobby. Hey, bro.
Hey, man, what's up?
Hey, did you ride him today?
No, I didn't.
You know, man.
Yeah, I know. You want to be there when I ride the dragon. I know, man.
I can't get enough of this flying.
Yeah.
This is so dang real.
What?
Hi, people.
Cool if he just barges in like that.
What's up?
I got something.
A movie?
No.
Netflix?
No.
A good TV show?
No. Your TV show. They want to re-up.
Yes!
Let's ride, pal!
Everyone else is in, they're just waiting on you.
This is good news, right?
Yeah.
Any thoughts on my script?
A few amigos over.
What? Dude, I had a long ass day. You have no idea. I just want to fucking sleep, and you're having a fucking party at my house?
You're a kid, man. Act like it. Get lit, man. Take a dip. You worked so hard for all this, bro. Enjoy it.
Bobby? Are your friends shooting a porno at my house?
They are not. Oh, wow, that's penetration. Yep, that's porno.
Oh, boy.
Fuck it. We'll be right back.
the night, huh?
Yeah, man.
I got laid, bro.
Yeah? Nice, man.
Yeah, I always wanted my first time to be special. And it was.
Cool, man.
It was amazing. I did a four-way with Bobby.
I don't even know what to say, dude. Congratulations.
Big bro, not a virgin no more!
I didn't know you were a virgin, dude. But it's...
Well, I mean, like...
That's no big deal, man. Don't even worry about it. That's cool.
Morning, dudes.
Hey.
I'm sorry, shit got weird last night. I know you didn't even want to have a party.
You know what? Don't even worry about it, man. I needed that.
I know you did. You hear about this little vulva jockey last night?
I did.
Brennan, the babes are still texting me about the size of your balls.
Really? Huh?
You seen them?
Nope.
Like avocados.
I'm sorry about the eye contact thing.
Oh, that's nothing, man.
I didn't know.
And next time, just keep the mask on. Yeah. But yeah, unbelievable. But seriously, get the nuts checked out, man.
Really?
Shit's not right. All right.
I love you guys.
What up? What are you doing this morning?
Follow me.
Let's go. What's up, PJ?
The network asked me to follow up. Are you gonna take the offer?
Do you have anything else for me?
How do you feel about lip sync battle?
There, buddy. Good news about the show, huh?
Woohoo!
Yeah. I mean, we're just like family here, right?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, Melanie and I practically raised you.
No, we did not, Gil. Okay? Fact. So just back it up, okay? That's desperate. And he knows how much fun we'd have doing another season. Don't you, hon, huh? Huh? Anyway, I'm gonna go back to my trailer now and, stretch. You know, yoga. You know, yoga.
Chase, how's it hanging?
Hey, man, yeah, just trying to be on my phone.
Well, it's funny, I was on my phone, so I have a picture of my daughter, see, my youngest. She sucked her thumb, so her teeth are all fucked up. See, they're real bad snaggle tooth there on the left.
Yeah, that
braces?
Sucks.
Mm-hmm. I know it sucks, braces. Mm-hmm. Very expensive.
Yeah, I got it.
Bobby. You're gonna get your nephew to take the offer, right? There are 100 jobs at stake. Think about the families. Let's keep riding, pal.
You got an angry crew out there. You shouldn't have this kind of pressure at 18.
Chase, you in there, hun? I'm wearing yoga pants. Anyone home?
I hate this fucking kid.
She's gone.
The show was supposed to be over. I was gonna ghost her. I don't know, man. I can't deal with her or the show anymore.
So you're out?
I don't know. I mean, I was talking to PJ and she was telling me about all these kid clients who never worked again after their shows. I just feel like I've worked too hard for that.
But you know the right thing to do. My fucking movie. You want to be DiCaprio? This is your Gilbert Grape.
It's nothing like Gilbert Grape.
I'll rewrite the script. I'll add a space fatty. Fuck it.
Why don't you go ahead and have a seat?
If you want another year, then we're gonna have to make some changes.
What do you want? Salary bump, bigger trailer, better snacks at Crafty?
Yeah, yeah, that sounds great, but also, I've got some story ideas.
Not gonna happen.
Then I'm out.
Wait! Okay.
Great. I'm gonna need something I can really sink my teeth into. Like, maybe a death in the family.
Hey, can I talk to you guys for a second? Please? As you know, this has been a pretty hectic time for all of us. And this isn't easy. I've grown up in front of you guys, and I know I haven't really been the easiest person to be around. And, you know, for that, I'm sorry. I didn't make this decision lightly. I've been yearning to do some important work, but a friend once told me the important work we're family, and this is home. Let's do another season, guys.
PJ, what's up?
I did it. I got you a movie.
What are you talking about?
It's a lead opposite Leo. Whatever you do, don't sign the contract.
Fuck.
Where I come from isn't all that great. My automobile is a piece of crap. My fashion sense is a little whack. And my friends are just as creepy as me. I didn't go to boarding schools. Preppy girls never looked at me. Why should they? I ain't nobody. Got nothing in my pocket.